We'll wrap up with DuPont Analysis, an important tool for management and others in understanding a business. Return on equity is a key figure for investors and management alike. DuPont Analysis breaks return on equity into three key ratios. First, the profit margin, measuring operational efficiency. The profit margin tells us how much net income is generated from each dollar of sales. The total asset turnover is a measure of efficiency or speed in turning over assets to generate sales. Finally, the equity measure is a measure of financial leverage. DuPont Analysis helps investors understand differences in return on equity and helps management pinpoint trouble areas and identify ways to improve return on equity. We saw that Microsoft had a return on equity of 28%, while Apple's return on equity was 35%. DuPont Analysis will help us understand how these different return on equities were derived. First, we'll break down return on assets. Breaking down return on assets allows investors to identify the components that are driving return on assets. Return on assets is equal to the net profit margin times the total asset turnover. We saw that Microsoft had the higher net profit margin at its year end. But Apple had a higher total asset turnover of 0.89 times per year as compared to Microsoft's 0.55 times. When we multiply these together, it results in a Microsoft return on assets of 15% and Apple's return on assets of almost 24%, much greater. Investors want to know if return on assets is moving up or down because of improvement or deterioration in the company's profit margin or its total asset turnover. Next, we'll break down return on equity. Return on equity in this format allows investors to identify the impact of leverage on the company's return. And return on equity is equal to the return on assets times the equity multiplier. The equity multiplier is a different ratio that is calculated by taking total assets divided by total stockholders' equity, and it's a measure of leverage. Okay, we saw return on assets 15.44 for Microsoft, 23% for Apple. When we multiply that times the equity multiplier, we have 1.80 for Microsoft and 1.49 for Apple. We see that Microsoft's leverage is higher than Apple's. But because of Apple's high return on assets, Apple still ends up with a higher return on equity of 35% than Microsoft's 28%. Investors want to know if return on equity is moving up or down because of how much debt the company is using or because how the firm is managing assets and operations. Remember that debt can also be risky. So, Microsoft's strengths were its profit margin and use of leverage. Apple's strengths were the total asset turnover, which gave it the higher return on assets, and finally the higher return on equity. So comparing the two, for Apple, it was the total asset turnover that drove ROE. For Microsoft, it was the profit margin and the use of leverage driving return on asset. Now, Microsoft and Apple are not exactly in the same industry, but they're both technology companies and roughly in the same industry. So they are fairly comparable. And that is important when we're comparing ratios. But let's take a look back at Boeing. Remember, we said in a prior segment that Boeing had a return on equity of 65%. How did they achieve that? Well, we really can't compare Boeing with Apple or Microsoft because the industries are too different. Boeing is a large manufacturer. Manufacturers often have a large investment in fixed assets like buildings, plants, and production equipment, as well as inventory, so often they have a lower total asset turnover. Depending on the competition, they may have a low profit margin as well. What we saw from Boeing is a profit margin of 5.47%, a total asset turnover of less than 1, which gave them a return on assets less than their profit margin of 4.38%. But when we take that return on assets and multiply it times their equity multiplier of 14.9, we get that return on equity of 65%. So their return on equity is definitely driven by leverage. I hope these videos have helped you understand how management and others use financial ratios to make greater sense of the financial data and be able to compare companies against their competition.